guys, I'm Spammy and welcome to another PlayStations for Warframe. Since I've been doing videos for Warframe, I actually resetted my account because I wanted my Platinum pack. The reasons for that is I wanted more weapon slots and more Warframe slots in exchange for the cosmetics that didn't really do anything too special, so that was a really bad choice of purchasing. So yeah, there is something to learn from that. What I plan to use during this gameplay is Frost Prime with this build: Energy Siphon, Constitution, Flow, Streamline and Continuity, Avalanche and Snow Globe, Rush, and eventually after I level up my Warframe two more times, I'm going to be able to equip Stretch, which increases the power range, which is pretty nice. The next is the weapon Brenton Vandal with Split Chamber, Wildfire, Hammer Shot, Serration, Point Strike, Piercing Hit and Rare Rounds. For the sidearms, and if you guys didn't know, the sidearms in Warframe are actually much more powerful than primary weapons, and the reason for that is that the mods for the sidearms are extremely powerful. For example, let me give you an example: Serration and Hornet Strike. Hornet Strike at rank 6 is 140% damage, right? Serration in exchange on rank 8, I think it is 135, and imagine that, two more levels lower and Hornet Strike is still more powerful, and that's the reason why sidearms are much more powerful, and they're really good to be used, especially the kunais and the disperdos are really OP. Not really OP, but still pretty strong. Dual Zorans are for traveling, and as I said, this is the loadout pretty much for Excalibur, which I plan to use in the future. During the last few updates, they added something really interesting. You get to select a animation that you want to have when you're going to be inactive, and for example Frost Agile animation and Noble animation, and this is available for all the other frames as well. So what are we going to do in this video? We're going to do the survival weekend mission, and in this mission we test pretty much the survival game mode, which is going to be available in update 10. So we're going to do that, and I want to do it solo, so let's start. Yeah, I'm going to do this solo. I'm targeting for 5 to 10 minutes. I don't want to go in a long run. I'm not sure how I'm going to survive with Frost Prime against Grineer. Maybe it's going to be easy, maybe not. I haven't been done this. I did the Corpus and Infested, so yeah. So let's go and try to survive for as much as we can during this game mode. Let's see, let's start this. During this game mode, all I have to do is pick up the oxygen for the other mods, from the other mobs. So killing mobs are going to reward me with oxygen, which are going to let me survive more in the game. So yeah, this is a big big room. There is a lot of running possible here. So yeah, using your ability is a pretty good idea. Staying in one place, getting some cover, of course, staying in the open like I do right now is not a really good idea. I should search for a place where the mobs come from one direction. It's going to be a lot easier to survive. So right now I'm not in any hurry to survive too much, but that's why I'm running all over the place. And as you can see, there is a guy over there. And as you can see, the snow globe lasts really long with constitution and continuity, which is the reason that I keep this warframe. putting another one over here, killing those guys if possible with the melee so I can get some XP. Yeah, all the fun things. By the looks of it, one of my friends are going to join the clan that I'm part in. Oh shit, 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 shit. Let's kill that those guys. Yeah, I'm not the wisest person right now doing all those crazy things, but I'm not in a hurry to survive, as I said, too much. And this game mode is actually really refreshing, is really fast, really fun. It starts really easy and then it gets a lot harder. And as you can see, I'm using the primary right now because the mobs are really easy to kill. Later on, I'm probably going to use my pistol and whatnot. And as you can see, I have the melee charge on my weapon, and that means whenever I use powers, my weapon is going to have a really big attack next time. Kind of, not all the time, but still, it's pretty fun. I'm not looking. Oh shit, I should be looking where those mobs are coming from. That's not a good idea. Yeah, and as you can see, the oxygen drops in small. What are those called? Drops or anything like that. And once upon some time, they're going to drop a really big. Power case that you activate and you get oxygen. So we're going to go here and let's see, snow globe, activate this, and it should give me a lot more oxygen. So yeah, staying over here should be pretty good, killing that guy. Going to get the oxygen. So yeah, I'm getting near 4 minutes. Yeah, it's 4 minutes. We're probably going to go on a 10 minutes mark. After that, I'm going to let the oxygen run out. I can probably go a 20 minutes run, but that's going to be boring for you guys because it's the same thing all over again, and yeah, whatnot. There is no point to defend in this game also, you can run how much you want. On Infested you're going to have a hard time because the drops for the Infested are pretty low on terms of oxygen and whatnot. Oh shit. You guys are really intense right now. You really do love to see me dying, which is not going to happen. Oh shit. Activating this. And I should probably survive. Another snow globe. And as you can see, new types of enemies come at key times. For example, at 10 minutes we should get the heavies. Probably those are going to be much more difficult to fight because they can knock you out, and they give enough time for the smaller mobs to kill you. And this guy is trying to really be annoying to me. Yeah, this is the survival mode. It's something different from all other game modes in Warframe. I guess I like it. Most of the times drops a lot of mods, but probably because I'm solo, it doesn't drop as much. And I mean, on private, so only a few friends are able to join. Yeah, I'm going to use my ability and crush all those baddies. And I got my first mod from this game mod. So this is the last oxygen bottle that I'm going to open. And then I'm going to try to defend in this place for as long as I have oxygen. And let's switch to the pistol. As you can see, it's damn powerful. No, can't do. The fuck just killed those baddies. Shit, I should look around. Okay, I want to pick up this resource over here and run back in my snow globe. Okay, killing this guy as well. Get the mod really fast. Oh, nice fusion core. Oh, how do I get the fusion core without? Okay, retribution. Pretty nice, pretty nice. That could be useful. And that's it, guys. That's it for this game mod. And that's it for this mission as well. So I really hope you like this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Ciao, guys.